graphic audio. A movie in your mind.
Graphic Audio and Archie Comics present Archie, Volume 5, by Mark Waid and Audrey Mock. Narrated by Bradley Foster Smith and performed by a full cast.
Chapter 1. Bruising.
5 days ago, I let Reggie Mantle bully me into a drag race. I knew it was a stupid thing to do. But at least I hit the "this is crazy stupid" brakes the second I saw Betty Cooper coming. Reggie did not.
No!
Crazy idiot!
She was driving up to stop us. And instead, Mantle's car accidentally knocked Betty's right off a cliff. I've loved Betty since we were kids. We're not a couple right now, but that doesn't change how I feel. Or how much I want to tear into Reggie with my bare hands. The crash put Betty in a coma.
Archie Andrews kneels next to Betty Cooper's hospital bed. The pale light of dawn illuminates the flowers that fill the room.
When she came out of it, she couldn't move her legs.
He brushes his fingers against her cheek.
Arch, good night.
Archie turns from Betty and looks sadly at her mother and father, sleeping in nearby chairs. They look worried and exhausted.
Mr. and Mrs. Cooper are waiting for a diagnosis. Pray for them.
Later, the Coopers sit in the doctor's office and listen as he explains the situation.
And we believe what Betty experienced is called a gliding contusion. Due to the impact of either the crash or the fall, Betty's brain experienced a bruising whiplash. That accounted for her coma. Now that she's conscious, we're running some tests to determine the extent of the damage and examine her spinal cord. It may be whole, and her paralysis may be due to some lesser form of trauma. But we need to prepare ourselves for a more realistic verdict. She needs, you need, to accept that Betty may be bound to a wheelchair.
Hal Cooper buries his face in his hands.
No. I'm sorry. Please tell her.
Tears appear in the doctor's eyes.
Please tell her that my daughter sends her best. She loves her little math tutor very much.
A wheelchair?
Back in Betty's hospital room, Archie is stunned by the news. Betty's mother, Alice, takes his hand.
Go on home, honey. We'll call you when she's ready for visitors.
Arch shakes his head in disbelief.
A wheelchair? That's not... Her whole life is baseball, and working on cars and track and field, and...
We know.
Betty's father, Hal, glares angrily at Archie. Arch hangs his head in guilt as he walks out of the room and into the hallway, where Veronica and Jughead are waiting for news.
Guys, we have to do something for Betty. Show her how much the whole town...
Archie slumps into a chair and hangs his head.
Something.
Chapter 2. Like, emails?
And Sheila, you write the get well cards to the veterans.
She does that too?
Well, you know, after her brother and all.
The next day at Pop's Chocolate Shop, Veronica Lodge, Sheila Wu, Tony Topaz, Raj Patel, and Jughead Jones are all huddled around the counter. Veronica is scribbling on paper, making a list.
Okay, that's not everything, but it's a start.
Pop Tate looks up from his cleaning duties.
You five sound busy.
We're gonna be. We're gonna show our support for Betty by filling in on all her volunteer work.
Pop leans in to look at the paper.
That's a long list.
That's why the entire town loves Betty Cooper. None of us had any real idea just how much she does for Riverdale. If we split these action items up, we may at least put a dent in...
In what?
They look up to see Archie, who is trying and failing, to
to look cheerful.
Figured you'd guys be here. What you working on?
All of the kids look like deer in headlights, frozen with panic. The last person in the world they wanted to show up was Archie, the perpetual klutz. The incredible ability of Archie to foul up the simplest of tasks was renowned around the town of Riverdale.
Stepping up to do all Betty's community work. There are only five of us, but we'll try to get to everything.
Six! Let me pitch in.
Hang on, sweetie.
Huh?
Veronica takes Archie by the arm and steers him away from the other kids, who prepare to shoot fingers.
Okay, on shoot. One, two, three, shoot!
Everyone's holding out two fingers except the dark-skinned, purple-haired Tony Topaz, who holds out one.
Oh!
They rejoin Archie and Veronica.
Archie, you're going to help Tony coach Pee-wee soccer.
Great!
Jughead watches with concern as a grinning Archie leaves with a sour-looking Tony.
Hey, Arch. Be careful, okay?
I'll be fine. Thanks.
Soon, Archie finds himself snarled in a goal net, being pummeled by junior soccer balls.
Help!
Tony sits on a bench with a clipboard, looking utterly exasperated.
Okay, no more laps if you can get him out of there. Don't use scissors, though, because you might hurt Mr. Andrew. Use scissors.
The Pee-wee soccer team manages to free Archie, who then approaches Tony sheepishly, covered in bits of string.
I'm more of a football guy, actually.
You don't say.
A soccer ball hits the back of his head.
Sorry. What do you need me to do?
Tony glares at him.
Go help Raj.
Later, at the park...
Just some basic gardening work, nothing complicated. Rake or mower?
Rake. I don't step on nearly as many of them as my dad says I do.
Mower, then. I gave Archie a lawnmower.
Later, at the Riverdale retirement community...
Hey, Jug. What you need doing?
I'm teaching the seniors about computer basics.
Like emails?
Exactly. Even you can send emails, Archie. Do you want to show them?
Sure.
Hey?
Nap time.
Where did the lights go?
Who turned out the lights?
How?
Chapter 3. Hurry.
Having monumentally screwed up every simple task assigned to him, Archie sits glumly on a curb, one foot stuck in a paint can, yellow paint splotching his freckled face and varsity jacket. A police officer approaches and looks down at the mess of a teenager.
Tell Betty, love from all of us at the precinct.
Will do.
The officer continues on his beat, and Archie is left alone with his thoughts.
It's not fair. I want to do something.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.